Hi, it's Simon. How are you all? Let's talk about the new Notion homepage and why its new features could be more powerful and useful than a lot of us might have realized to plug our systems into. So the new features and look of Notion Home make it a big departure, the biggest departure, I think, in style from Notion ever. And despite my trepidation in using it, it's good. Now, where Notion is usually the kind of, you know, productive Lego that you can kind of build whatever you want with, this is a little bit different. It's Notion giving us a more focused UI that they've designed to kind of connect to those systems. But listen, if you're a Notion purist, don't let that put you off just yet. Use the new features recently announced in Home right, and it's super cool. And for new users, it's so useful to link to whatever you've built elsewhere. So let me show you all the new updates that are here and how I'd use them in conjunction with something like a LifeOS template, yeah, or second brain setup. And that includes quick menus, a really super cool new database view, and probably my favorite, the My Tasks view, which took me a while to work out, but it brings a completely new capability to a Notion operating system that we've never had before. Different databases can link into it. And on the subject of a Notion LifeOS, a bunch of you are probably wanting to know when my new complete Notion LifeOS template will be ready, right? Well, thank you to all of you waiting patiently for that new version. Let me briefly update you on where I'm at with it. So feel free to skip to the next chapter if you don't need to hear this. So for those of you out there interested in this, my complete LifeOS is being worked on right now alongside a bunch of supporting videos in this update along. And that is taking me a little more time. Now, the reason I'm doing that is that many of you may want to be able to make some of the kind of key adjustments that I'm making to the system into your own system rather than having to move all of your data across or start clean, which can be a bit annoying. This in part is why it's taking me a little bit longer than expected to get this done. And you know, it's just me. It's quite a time here at Better Creating as well at the moment. I'm recruiting a member of staff to help me. I'm updating my Notion resources and website. There's loads going on, but I promise I will email you if you own one as soon as it's ready in beta, and I will make noise on here as well. So it's probably beta is going to be ready end of July for existing owners, and I'll launch the public version after that for anyone who wants it fresh. So if you are new and are interested in this, you could join the waiting list for the complete LifeOS. There's some cool new habit tracker systems turning up in this, which I'm very pleased about. And if you can't wait, jump across and grab my simplified Notion LifeOS, and I will send you a link so you could upgrade from that to the complete one if you like it. So this is the latest version of Notion's homepage, and it's worth saying this is only available on the web browser or desktop like I have here. So you can't get this on mobile or iPad at the moment. These views though up the top, these quick jump back views, are available on the mobile app, and it echoes that. But let's start with the wonderful and welcome addition of being able to see our Notion calendar. I would love it if Notion would design this so that it could also be dropped in as an element in the rest of your system, but the request is out there, right, Notion? But for now, it works on Home beautifully. With this view, if you have a Notion calendar account and you are signed in to that on the same device, you can connect it here just by clicking. There's a view to do it. And you can jump to the Notion calendar, open in Notion calendar. I can just jump across and see everything that's in there. The great thing about this is you can bring multiple Google accounts and down here, Notion databases into this view in one go, which is so great for scheduling. So I might want to align meetings with planned workload, tasks that come from the task database, and perhaps even content, like I have a content calendar item in here. I can see it all within here. There are ways to see the entire week there, or we can change that within this to like just be today. I can also adapt this to be 3 days, today and tomorrow. We can select the calendars that show up. So currently I have just certain selected calendars showing, but if I just mirror the calendar app, it will just copy everything that is going on in my calendar app. That is probably the best way to use it. Why am I getting excited about this? Well, we're waiting for this kind of integration, and it's good to see it. So I can create events within it as well here. It will jump me to the place to do it, which is rather nice, to the other calendar. That's a nice touch. And probably my favorite situation here is this, actually. We can show and hide all day events, but events without participants and events without conferencing and location. So this means if I turn this off, I will only see the meetings that involve external people. If you're working in a team, this could be really helpful to check what your fundamental commitments are. But personally, I like having this on and using it as my day view. This is particularly cool if you want to time block out your tasks, say in a tasks database, and then view them here. If you want to know more about using Notion Calendar, check out my dedicated video after this. I'll link it below for a full tour on how to make the most of it. But next, the most significant update, in my opinion, to Home has got to be the next section, my tasks. The big news is that we are now able to do something we've never been able to do before in Notion: view items from separate databases within one view. So for a database to qualify as a usable source for your task view, you can use any database to feed into this, but it has to have certain properties. So if we click on properties, the fundamental ones it has to have is an assignee or a person column, a status column that you link, and a due date or due date column. So essentially a date, a status, and a person. And if you have that, you can turn anything into one of these. So here we have all of the views from my Better Creating Team tasks, and click on the view, you can see this new view of customizing the databases. And it's a really nice way to do things. You can get things to estimate and do tag. And what I've got here is I've set it to be seen in the tasks database. So what if I wanted to add my personal tasks from this database over here? So let's click through into my this week's view of my personal task database. To add this to a task list, we click on the three-dot menu and we go to customize, add it as a task database. I'm going to click that and you'll see the options we now have. So it's already picked the assignee. I want to click status because that is my status thing here. And then I want to pick a property and I'm going to do my due date. I call it that. It's a date property. I'm going to turn that into a tasks database. And if we jump back into the my tasks view, we should see it in here. Well, there's only one of them, and that's probably for good reason. If I click on the view of it, it's because it's assigned to me. But in a personal task database, I don't always assign my tasks to myself. So what we need to do is modify the assignee filter. I'm going to jump into the filter. I'm actually going to click on the one there, and we're going to select the dots and add to an advanced filter. And I'm going to add that, and I'm going to make this or where source is the tasks database. And that you'll see has now updated so that I can see all of my tasks from my task database in there as well. Now there are some key limitations here to the tasks view at the moment. So you can only view certain properties which are limited. And this is because it's required properties that have to be there. So sadly, you can't do something like view the related project to that item. We have some other hidden typical properties that are just naturally in all databases, but we can't do anything more than that at the moment. But you know what? How good is that? That's showing me all of my in progress or not started tasks that are linked to me across different databases and when they're due. I think that is super powerful. So if you want to learn more about task management essentials in Notion, you can watch this video next via my link below and even download my free task and project template to use it with. Oh, and while you're there, don't forget to subscribe. Next in the home view, we have a database view widget, which sits below the My Tasks area. And this, I've got to say, is my favorite. It was recently released by Notion and it allows you to basically show any view of any database in whatever way you want. And this is really powerful. So you'll see, for example, because the tasks view doesn't show, say, calendar views, I've actually set myself up with a view here. So if we click into here and we edit this, we can see that this is linked to my same team tasks database, but I've set myself up with a weekly view, just Monday to Friday, of tasks in a calendar. But it goes much further than this because it's really valuable. You can set your own filters and sorts and bring in multiple databases to this. So this is a view of my knowledge base, in my second brain, where I can see my live and consuming items and my reading list. And you just do all of this with filters, right? So I've got a status of just the stuff that's important to me here. Now you can actually draw something in from any view and edit it here. I'm actually updating my LifeOS template at the moment to be compatible with views that will feed into this view for people if they want to do it. So to add a new view, we click into here. I'm going to click on add view. I can find any database here, the content database. Let's click on it. Now you can bring any view you've created in the original database and duplicate it here, like you would do with a linked view. But you can't duplicate linked views that you might have on dashboards. And that is a modification that I'm going to make to my template so it's easier for you guys to use it. But for example, why don't we have a little look at the main view? This is just everything in my content calendar. And I can quickly now filter this view as I wish. I'm going to rename it. So you can go in, click here, rename. You can add properties. Let's make it that. And this is live videos, say. I will go into filter, find the content type, YouTube video. I would like the published to be unchecked. And I would like one more filter, which is published date. And I'm going to set that is this month. So it's everything I'm working on this month. I'm going to remove the grouping because I don't need that. And then I can just hide properties. So this is why you want your database to have already got a clean view that you want to use for this. So I would propose you build the view you want in your database if you're doing this, and then you can just drop what you need in here, jump through to the one I'm working on. Here it is. See what's in there. I can see all the information directly from my homepage. Jump back, all your relevant information in one useful place. I'm absolutely loving that. Now, there are a few more features here too on the homepage that we can quickly check out and even customize. We have a learn section and we have a featured template section. Some people can even get a suggested to you view, but I don't seem to have that. Not quite sure why. If you wanted to customize this, there's a little bit of stuff we can do. You click the three dot menu in the top right and go to show and hide widgets, and I can hide those bottom ones that I don't need if I don't want them there. And notice here we've got the change the default start page. This is something in Notion. Every time you log in, you want it to go to a certain place. If you set it to home, it jumps to this rather nice dashboard. And I'm actually starting to love that because it will take me back to my recent things and I have a view of everything. Finally, on the customization front, this is a cracker. You can edit your nickname. So we could change this to, if you want a bit of pepping up. I hope that gets you making the most of Notion Home. And if you are new or newer to Notion, definitely jump over to bettercreating.com where you can download my free template for task and project management down the bottom here for free completely. It's a full system. You can use it alongside Notion Home and get yourself moving. And if you want to go a bit further and learn the basics of using Notion to manage your life, check out my Notion from Scratch course. It's a full list of YouTube videos that will get you through building an entire system. And finally, there is, of course, in my Notion downloads area, a set of Second Brain LifeOS templates if you just want to skip the building work and jump to the good stuff. The perfect tool to manage all your tasks and knowledge in one place, so that you don't have to. So I will be back here as soon as possible with that LifeOS update. And in the meantime, if you want to see how far you can take Notion for personal productivity, watch this video next, or this one for the best productivity system I know to never forget a task again. It would be awesome if you subscribed here. If you haven't, leave a like and a comment, and I'll see you on the next one.